much welcome to help or to protect their own bodies. Sometimes when you have some experience, if you have very young and strong muscles, and if you do some very tough sports, you can be seriously injured. But for me, my muscle strength is so much reduced, impossible to introduce a big force to me. Therefore, I have some damage, but not like me. Something like that. So if we talk about unexpected big events, which strategy is good? Very strong, very strong. It's so very strong. But if the enemy is so much stronger than the result, afterward, it's miserable. But if the enemy is not well expected, so let us behave like that. This is some concept. About 15 years ago, many structural engineers investigated the value of phi, shear capacity and intercapacity ratio, and also about 3,000 reinforced concrete columns were investigated, each by each. One column investigated, and they calculated the bending moment, shear capacity, 3,000. About 50 engineers worked for 3 months, from 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. Right. And these figures are a summary. Therefore, we obtain that when the phi value is less than 0.8, without any exception, this structure will not survive. But if the phi value is more than 1.8, without any exception, so no collapse, and the reuse was possible. Therefore, this one is a criterion of strengths for a good design, was decided. But I think this is a case of the old structures constructed about half a century ago. Then, based upon this, so we check. This case, phi is almost 1.0. This is not good, this is not good. But the engineers judge that this is not no need to strengthen. Of course, damage exists, but no need. Actually, a very miserable failure, but no direct shear failure. Still, this superstructure could be supported by several materials. Please understand that about 300 kilometers of the Shinkansen line was investigated in the past 5 years. Every class were investigated. And engineer judged, when the earthquake comes, maybe this can be miserably damaged, but still this can survive. Then intentionally, they did not strengthen. They did not strengthen these structures. Therefore, this is just one scenario. Therefore, precisely 1.0 is not so good, but it's okay. But if this is 0.8 or 0.7, maybe like that. But some engineers said that this should be 1.2 or 3 for the judgment of strengthenings or non-strengthenings. When we have this 1.2, 1.3, and if the structures having value smaller than this would be strengthened, it takes so much money. Right. But if this one is 0.9, 0.8, some structures will need to strengthen. Therefore, one is okay. But there is a risk. Therefore, please understand, this is a judgment. And if we have so much rich persons, this should be 1.2, 1.5, or 3. Right? So if the structure is less than this, everything structures will be strengthened. The finance hours do that. It is the best way. But no. Therefore, now in the case of the railway infrastructure, this is 0.8. Therefore, we suppose that 0.9, this is a really border. Therefore, through this Shinkansen line, many engineers are so much worried about the distributions. For this case, maybe. But if the value of phi is less than 0.8, without any exceptions, strengthening must be done. And also, about a few years ago, all strengthening was completed. Therefore, some infrastructures having some steel jacketing was because of this PU, it's really like that. When we put some steel casing or a double reinforcing mass, this body is increased, the biomarker is increased. Yeah, this is a very typical way of upgrade performances. So unfortunately, some part have been already strengthened. This used to be the very bare structures, having small values of power. But after that, this was upgraded and there was no condition, there's no system collapse. This one, still 1.0. We suppose that this is the standard. This is really, this is a redundancy, but engineers judge, no need. If they have money, okay. If they have money, they must strengthen this part. But because of this finance, they did. But I heard that according to the year, they will have some profit. Then